Hassam.
Alaikum, dear friends. Kushali Mubarak to you all and your families. We are now in the Islamic month of Rabiul Awal. There are two special people whose birthdays we celebrate this month. Does anyone know whose birthday are in this blessed month? We are celebrating the birthday of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, and our sixth Imam, Imam Ja'far as-Sadiq alayhi salam, who share the same birthday. Now, don't go anywhere, as we have a story for you on Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. So stay tuned. The air was hot and dry, and the sky was pitch black in the quiet city of Mecca. A little bird sat on the windowsill, chirping to comfort a woman in pain. This special woman was Amina, and she would soon become the mother of the best creation of Allah. It was almost time for Fajr, and Amina's pain started to increase. All of a sudden, by the miracle of Allah, a powerful light burst through the sky, and the cries of a newborn baby echoed. Amina had given birth to baby Muhammad. If you were in Mecca that night, you would have seen a beautiful bright light shining all over the sky, telling you that something special had just happened. Do you want to know what other miracles happened at the exact moment of Prophet Muhammad's birth? Idols from all around the world fell down on their faces. The castles of the greedy kings began to crack and shake, and Shaitan began screaming as he realized that with the birth of this special child, he was going to lose. What a special child indeed! As Amina held her sweet baby close to her, an angel entered her house and said, "O Amina, you are now the mother of the best creation of Allah. This baby will become a leader for mankind, and everyone and everything will praise him. So name him Muhammad, the praised one." Amina was so happy to hear how blessed her baby was. She thanked Allah and immediately began calling him Muhammad, the praised one. Early that morning, Abdul Muttalib, the grandfather of the Prophet, rushed to Amina's house as soon as he heard the good news. As he thanked Allah for this beautiful blessing, he gently took baby Muhammad, who was wrapped in a pure white cloth, and headed towards the Kaaba. For a special blessing, he rubbed baby Muhammad against the four corners of the Kaaba. The news of baby Muhammad's birth traveled throughout the city of Mecca. Everyone wanted to know about the baby that had made the sky turn bright. One man asked Abdul Muttalib, "What have you named your grandson?" Abdul Muttalib excitedly told them the story of how an angel delivered Allah's message to name the baby Muhammad. However, the people still did not understand why he was called the praised one. 1 year, there was a severe drought in Mecca. As a result, the farms had dried up and the sheep and camels were dying without any water to drink. People all over Mecca tried to come up with a solution to fix this big problem. They prayed to their idols and even sacrificed the sheep to them. However, nothing they did worked. Finally, an old man suggested, "We should ask Abdul Muttalib to help us, since he is from the family of Prophet Ibrahim." When the people came to Abdul Muttalib, he thought for a little while and then took young Muhammad's hand and led him towards the Kaaba. He gently placed Muhammad's hand on the Kaaba and loudly called out 3 times, "O Allah, for the sake of Muhammad, send rain upon us." A few seconds later, the people watched in shock as the clouds began to gather, turning from white to gray.
There was a loud clap of thunder. All of a sudden, rain began pouring down from the sky. The people of Mecca were so happy. They rejoiced in the streets, kissing and hugging the Prophet out of gratitude. After this extraordinary miracle, even more people started to love and respect Muhammad. And at the age of 40, Allah ordered him to announce that he was a prophet. With his prophethood, he would bring mercy and peace to everyone.
Muhammad grew up under the care of his grandfather, Abdul Muttalib. He grew into a strong and compassionate young man who was always willing to help everyone. Anytime someone would leave something with him, he would guard it very carefully. So everyone began calling him Muhammad al-Amin, which means Muhammad, the trusted one. He was so trustworthy that whenever people had a problem, they would always ask him for help. One day, Prophet Muhammad was passing through the streets of Medina when a wise Jewish man came up to him. He stared at the Prophet's lovely face and asked, "O Muhammad, I have read your name in the holy books. I read that you are also named Ahmad. Why were you given these names?" Prophet Muhammad smiled and said, "I am known as Muhammad on the earth and Ahmad in the heavens, because everyone, including those in the heavens, will like and praise my good deeds." So as you can see, the news that the angel had brought to Amina was indeed true when he said, "Your child's name is Muhammad because he is the best creation of Allah and everyone will praise him." May Allah's peace and blessings be upon Prophet Muhammad al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wasallam, Allah's best creation who is praised all over this earth and in the heavens.
Make sure to like and subscribe.
And don't forget to share.